During May and June, staff from the North Carolina Wildlife Resources Commission's Wildlife Diversity Program travel the state from Corolla to Sunset Beach, surveying waterbirds that nest on our coast. Biologists visit beaches, islands, and marshes, documenting what species are present and how many pairs nest at a location. There are a variety of methods used to survey. Ground surveys are conducted either on foot or from boats or vehicles. Surveys can also be done by plane or with the use of drones. These surveys teach us about the abundance and distribution of nesting sea, wading, and shorebirds. Some of the islands, like this one near Atlantic North Carolina, were created from dredge material and are protected by the Commission as a way to provide waterbirds with a safe place to raise their young, free from human disturbance. Colonial waterbirds, like brown pelicans, nest in colonies that provide safety in numbers, while American oyster catchers and other shorebirds nest as individual pairs and use distraction to lead predators away from the nest. Herons and egrets nest in trees, bushes, and some grasses. American oyster catchers stand out from other birds with their yellow eyes and long orange bill. Reports of a decline in the American oyster catcher population prompted the commission to begin surveying the species in 2004. Since then, the number of pairs has increased. Due to the use of DDT, the number of brown pelican nests along our coast fell to as low as 101 in 1977 when they were first surveyed. Thanks to the work of conservationists, the species is now thriving. While many waterbird populations are declining, conservation work has reversed the trend for American oyster catchers and brown pelicans. A true conservation success story.